I'm Katrina Du, welcoming you to Step Into the Valley with the 3-Step Realty Group. Today, we're going to talk about 9 mistakes that buyers make when purchasing their home. The first one, and possibly the most important one, is not knowing your buying power, or not knowing how much home you can actually afford. Which goes hand in hand with mistake number 2, and that's home hunting before knowing your buying power. If you go out there and you start looking for homes before knowing how much home you can afford, quite possibly one of 2 things could happen. You could go out looking at homes, fall in love with a home, and then find out you can actually afford a whole lot more home. But if you fell in love with that one, that's not necessarily a bad thing, right? But what if you're on the opposite end of that and you go out looking at homes, you fall in love with a home and find out that the ones that you like, you can't afford? Well, that's why it's important to talk to your lender and know what your buying power is before you go out looking. Now, mistake number 3 is not moving fast enough. So sometimes buyers find out what they can afford or what their buying power is, but they don't complete the pre-approval process yet because they want to wait till they find that perfect home. Now, when you generally have this mistake happen, not moving fast enough, it's when buyers are looking for that move-in ready, great condition home, priced great, priced perfect, and there's other buyers also loving that home, and they can't write an offer on it yet because they haven't completed their pre-approval process. So they have to go back to their lender and have them start and complete the full pre-approval process and get their letter that they can include with their offer. So while those other buyers are writing offers, they quite possibly could miss the opportunity of that home they fell in love with. Now, mistake number 4 is not considering other expenses with that home. So let's take, for example, let's say that you live in an apartment or a townhouse or condo and you don't have a yard, and then you buy a home with a big yard to maintain. Now, expenses aren't necessarily finance or monetary. It could mean your time, where you've never had to budget time to maintain that big yard before. You now have to budget time for it. Or what if you can't? You don't have any time. Well, then you have to pay someone, or you could pay someone, to maintain it for you, and then it starts getting into a finance expense you didn't consider before. Or let's say that you buy a home in a really hot area and that home has a swimming pool that's gorgeous, but you didn't consider the cost of maintaining that swimming pool. Now, these aren't bad things. These are just things to consider to make sure you can afford them with this particular home that you want to buy. Now, mistake number 5 is not having inspections performed on the home. Let's put this in a different scenario. You're car shopping and you are looking online and you find a great opportunity of a car for $5,000 from someone that just lives in the neighborhood. You call the person, say, "I love the description. I love what you said about the car. $5,000, I'm buying it, hold it for me." You go, you give that person the money, and then you drive away with the car. So when you're driving away, you find out the blinker doesn't work, the brakes squeal, it's making some ticking noise that you don't know what it is. Had you pre-drove it or test drove it, had you had inspections done on it or had it serviced, you would have found those things before you bought it, and you could have either walked away and said, "You know, I don't think this car's for me," or you could have negotiated that $5,000 price for that car. Same concept for a house. So get inspections done, or at least get the bare minimum ones of the ones your agent recommends for you. Now, mistake number 6 is lacking vision. Many times sellers don't clear out their home of all their personal pictures or belongings, or thin out how much furniture they have in the home. And it's hard for buyers to look past all those things of the sellers, their furniture, the seller's belongings, all that stuff. So it's really important to try to look past it and picture yourself there, or the opportunity, your furniture, your family. Try to look past their belongings, their furniture, and all that good stuff. Now, mistake number 7 is being too picky. What I mean by that is sometimes when you create your list of what you want in a house, there's 2 defined lists there. There's a "I need this in a house" and "I want this in a house." And sometimes there are buyers, the ones that have take a long time finding that right home for them, are trying to check off not only everything on their need list, but everything on their want list. And getting 100% of those items is really rare to come by. So if you find that great home and that great opportunity that meets all of your needs and most of your wants, and you can put those wants in later on, don't pass up on it. Now, mistake number 8, letting a need become a want. So when you created that needs list, you sat down initially and said, we need to have this in a home. We have 5 kids, so we need to have 4 bedrooms. And maybe when you're out looking, you didn't find any 4 bedroom homes that you loved or 5 bedrooms, but what you did find was a 3 bedroom home. So you went ahead and decided, or the buyer decided that, you know what, we love this home. I know we've got 4 kids, but we'll just pair more of them up. Let's buy this 3 bedroom home. Those needs that you set in place, do everything you can to stick to them, because those are the things that are going to make you happy every day that you wake up in that home. Now, we have mistake number 9, and that's not hiring a great agent. First and foremost, a great agent is going to help you make sure you don't make any of mistakes 1 through 8. A great agent is also going to help you define the market and what's happening in the market at the time you're looking to buy. And a great agent will help you negotiate so you don't overpay and you get a great house within your buying power. And if you are thinking about buying a home and you need a great agent to talk to, call us here at the 3-Step Realty Group. We're here to help you find that perfect home.